friends, today we are going to learn the numerical problems based on lime soda process. Before going deep into the process, let us see the formula for the lime requirement and soda requirement. The lime requirement formula is, lime requirement is equal to 74 upon 100 multiplied by temporary calcium, 2 times temporary magnesium, permanent magnesium, aluminium and iron, H plus CO2, HCO3 minus sodium aluminate, all in terms of calcium carbonate equivalent. Soda requirement is equal to 106 upon 100. There are no temporary compounds here. Temporary hardness is not here in the formula. Only permanent is there. Permanent calcium, magnesium, aluminium, iron, H plus minus HCO3 minus, all in terms of CaCO3 equivalent. Let us see how to calculate multiplication factor. We know that the degree of hardness of water is usually expressed in terms of calcium carbonate because of its molecular weight as 100. It is easy to calculate the hardness in terms of CaCO3 equivalent because of its molecular weight as 100. The equivalence of CaCO3 for a hardness producing substance is equal to weight of the hardness producing substance multiplied by chemical equivalent of CaCO3, which is nothing but equal to 50, divided by chemical equivalent of hardness producing substance. Chemical equivalent of CaCO3 upon chemical equivalent of hardness producing substance is nothing but equal to its multiplication factor. Or else we can say that the equivalence of CaCO3 for a hardness producing substance is equal to weight of hardness producing substance multiplied by its multiplication factor. Let us see how we are going to calculate the multiplication factor. For example, we have the hardness producing substance as calcium carbonate. Its molecular weight is 100. How do we calculate the molecular weight? Atomic mass of calcium is 40. It is a 20th element. So its atomic mass is 40. Carbon is the 6th element. Its atomic mass is 12. Oxygen is the 8th element. Its atomic mass is 16. So 16 multiplied by 3 plus 12 plus 40. It will come out to be 100. Okay. And its equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by its valency. Now see, multiplication factor is equal to chemical equivalent of calcium carbonate upon chemical equivalent of hardness producing substance. In this case, the hardness producing substance is calcium carbonate itself. So chemical equivalent of CaCO3 is equal to 50, and chemical equivalent of the hardness producing substance, which is nothing but its equivalent weight, it's again 50. So it is 50 upon 50. Multiplication factor is 50 upon 50 or 100 upon 100. So 100 and its equivalent weight is 50. Multiplication factor is equal to 50 upon 50 or 100 upon 100. Let us consider another example, calcium bicarbonate. How do we calculate the molecular weight for this? Calcium is 40 and there are two HCO3 minus ions attached with this calcium. So for HCO3 minus, we have hydrogen as 1, carbon as 12, oxygen as 16, atomic mass multiplied by 3. The whole sum will come out to be 61. 61 multiplied by 2 plus 40. It will be 162. Because its valency is 2, the equivalent weight will be equal to 162 divided by 2, which is nothing but 81. Again, let us see how the multiplication factor will be calculated. Chemical equivalent of CaCO3 is 50 upon the substance is calcium bicarbonate here. So equivalent weight of CaCO3 upon equivalent weight of the substance, which is nothing but calcium bicarbonate, which is 50 upon 81. 50 divided by 81 is the multiplication factor, or we can say that 100 upon 162. Similarly, we can calculate the multiplication factor for all these compounds. If you see all these compounds, all these have calcium and magnesium ions, which has valencias too. So we can say that the multiplication factor is nothing but 100 upon its molecular weight itself. There is no need of calculation of equivalent weight in these cases. So this is 100 upon 162. 162 is its molecular weight. 136, it is 100 upon 136, and so on. Let us consider another example. Let us take sodium aluminate as example. Sodium aluminate, it is 11th element, atomic mass is 23. Aluminium is 13th element, 27 is atomic mass. Oxygen is 8th element, 16 is the atomic mass. So if we calculate molecular mass for that, 16 multiplied by 2 plus 27 plus 23, that will come out to be 82. Because it is having valencias 1, we have molecular weight and equivalent weight the same. That is, chemical equivalent or equivalent weight is nothing but is equal to 82 itself. So the multiplication factor will come out to be, the formula was chemical equivalent of CaCO3, that is 50, divided by chemical equivalent of the hardness producing substance, which is nothing but sodium aluminate. So sodium aluminate is its atomic mass we have calculated as, molecular mass we have calculated as 82, and equivalent weight is 82 itself. So it is 50 upon 82 or 100 upon 82 multiplied by 2. So if we calculate for valency, similarly, if you calculate for HCO3 minus, it is again having molecular mass as 61. Equivalent weight is also 61 because its valency is 1. So 100 upon 50 upon 61 or 100 upon 61 multiplied by 2. So we can say that the compounds which have valency as 1 will have multiplication factor as 100 upon molecular weight into 2. So for easy calculations, we can directly, you can remember it as 100 divided by molecular weight into 2. There is an exemption of aluminium sulfate. If you calculate molecular weight for aluminium sulfate, aluminium is 27th element, so 27 multiplied by 2, plus sulfur is 32, oxygen is 16 multiplied by 4, the sum must be multiplied with 3, plus 2 times 27. It will come out to be 342. Its equivalent weight is 342 divided by 6. So multiplication factor is 50 upon 57. 50 is equivalent weight of CaCO3 and 57 is equivalent weight of aluminium sulfate. So 50 upon 57 is a multiplication factor, or in terms of 100, it is 100 upon 114. So if you calculate for any of the compound, you can see the one which is having the atomic, the valency as 2 will have multiplication factor as 100 divided by its molecular weight. And the one which is having valency as 1 will have the multiplication factor as 100 divided by molecular weight into 2, or its atomic mass in this H plus case, it is 1, it is 100 divided by 1 into 2. And the exception was only aluminium sulfate, which was 100 upon 114. And in all other cases, we can consider all, most of the compounds will have 100 upon its molecular weight if the valency is 2. See, for calcium 2 plus valency is 2, 100 upon its molecular weight is atomic mass is 40. For HCl, it is 36.5. And valency is 1. So 100 upon 36.5 multiplied by 2 because its valency is 1. For H2SO4, valency is 2. So 100 upon molecular weight itself, you can take, it is 98. There is no need of multiplying it by 2. Let us calculate, let us solve one of the question where we have a water sample containing 204 milligram of calcium sulfate per liter. Calculate the hardness in terms of CaCO3 equivalent. So we know that hardness of water we calculate in terms of CaCO3 equivalent. The formula is the amount that is given, the amount of the substance that is given multiplied by its multiplication factor. So the amount is given as 204 milligram multiplied by multiplication factor is 100 upon 136 for calcium sulfate. Calcium is 40, sulfur 32, oxygen is 16. So 16 multiplied by 4 plus 32 plus 40 will come out to be 136. Because its valency is 2, I said 100 upon its molecular weight. So 204 multiplied by 100 upon 136 will come out to be the amount in terms of CaCO3 equivalent. So hardness is equal to this 150 milligram per liter, because the water sample is given as per liter. So it is for 1 liter. So 150 milligram per liter is the hardness of water. Let us take another example. A sample of water has the following constituents: magnesium carbonate 42 milligram per liter, HCO3 minus, and all this we have the amount in terms of milligram per liter. So we need to calculate the quantity of lime and soda required for complete softening of 50,000 liters of hard water. Let us see, these are the constituents. We have the amount. We can make a table of constituents, amount, multiplication factor, and calcium carbonate equivalent hardness as heading. And we have constituents. You can write it here, the constituents. The amount has been given. We need to calculate the multiplication factor. As I said you before, magnesium carbonate will have multiplication factors 100 upon its molecular weight as 84. This will have 100 upon its molecular weight into 2. So 61 into 2 is 122. Magnesium sulfate has valency as 2. So 100 upon its molecular weight. This also will have 100 upon its molecular weight. And the aluminium sulfate will have 100 upon 114, which is nothing but I already said you that the multiplication factor is 50 upon 57 or 100 upon 114. We can calculate the CaCO3 equivalent hardness by multiplying the amount with multiplication factor. So amount is 42 multiplied by its multiplication factor. 42 multiplied by 100 upon 84 is 50. We can calculate all this CaCO3 equivalent hardness for all these constituents. Sodium chloride do not impart any hardness. So you don't need to calculate the amount, the multiplication factor or the CaCO3 equivalent for sodium chloride. Let us put all these in the formula. So we have this formula that I have already discussed. So in the formula, if you see, we have temporary calcium. So let us see whether temporary calcium is there. We don't have any temporary calcium. We have only calcium chloride, which is not temporary. So temporary calcium means all the carbonate hardness of calcium. So we don't have any carbonate hardness of calcium here. We have only chloride here, plus 2 into temporary magnesium. We have temporary magnesium as magnesium carbonate. Permanent magnesium we have as magnesium sulfate. Aluminium as aluminium sulfate. We don't have iron here, nor the acids. Carbon dioxide is also, it's absent from the constituent. HCO3 minus is there, so we have to calculate HCO3 minus. Sodium aluminate is also absent. So let us see, the formula will become 74 upon 100 bracket. 2 multiplied by magnesium carbonate, because we don't have temporary calcium here, so we are taking only temporary magnesium, plus magnesium sulfate, plus aluminium as aluminium sulfate, plus HCO3 minus, multiplied by volume of water. So we need to, because we need to calculate, we are calculating the lime requirement in terms of milligram, so we are multiplying it with volume of water. So this, all these quantities is in milligram per liter and volume of water in liter, so we get the value in terms of milligram per, in the amount as milligram. So see, magnesium carbonate we have value as 50, and magnesium sulfate we have 100, aluminium sulfate we have 200, HCO3 minus we have as 100. We can put all these values and we can multiply it with volume of water. So we'll get this value in terms of milligram, because we are taking, we are multiplying it with volume of water, 50,000 liter. Okay. And in kg, we can, if you divide it with 10 to the power of 6, we will get the value in terms of kg. Now, we have soda requirement formula we have already discussed. We see, let us see the constituents. So we don't have any temporary constituents here. We have only permanent the hardness. So permanent calcium is there as calcium chloride. Permanent magnesium is there as magnesium sulfate. Permanent aluminium is there as aluminium sulfate. Iron is absent. H plus or HCl is absent, as all the acids are absent, and we have HCO3 minus, so minus HCO3 minus all in terms of CaCO3. So in place of calcium, we can write it as calcium chloride, and in place of magnesium as magnesium sulfate. In place of aluminium, we have aluminium sulfate minus HCO3 minus. Multiplied by volume of water as 50,000 liters. We can put the values here and see we have magnesium value of magnesium sulfate as 100, calcium chloride as 100, and aluminium sulfate as 200, and HCO3 minus as 100. And multiplied by the volume of water as 50,000 liters. So we get the value in terms of milligram, because all these values are in terms of milligram per liter. As we already know the calculation, we have done it in terms of milligram per liter multiplied by volume of water in liter. So the amount will come out to be in terms of milligram. If we convert it into kg, we can divide it with 10 to the power of 6. So this will come out to be 15.9 kg. That's all for today. Thank you, everyone.